Hello again, this is BGFH, and welcome back to Illegally Sighted, and today we're going to take a quick look at a couple of indie games here. And this may be one or two videos, I'm not yet sure if or how I'm going to split these up. The two games we're going to look at today are called Gravity Bone and 30 Flights of Loving. So, yeah, really weird names, and yeah, we'll leave it at that for now. But basically, the main game we're going to be looking at here is 30 Flights of Loving. It's available through Steam. I picked it up on sale a while back, and I just hadn't had a chance to really play it. I still have yet to play it, so I really have no idea what to expect. I just know it's a really short indie game. However, the 30 Flights of Loving is supposed to be a sequel of sorts to a game called Gravity Bone, which does happen to be included in this package. And we're going to start out by doing that just to refresh my memory. I have played this. Gravity Bone was released for free a few years ago, and we'll give it a shot here. So when you start the game, you're brought up into this little menu here, and we're going to just go to this first option here. Now we have, we have kind of a main menu here with our options. Print is sort of small, but at least there's really nice contrast. You know, as you can tell, we got 30 Flights 11. We have actually have a commentary mode, which I have yet to look at either, which I definitely want to check that out on my own. But here we have Gravity Bone. Let's try this. All right. So let's see if I can remember anything about this game. Alright, so you can tell right away that the graphics are really stylized. Like I said, this version of the Gravity Bone part came out a while ago. So I have played through this before. You're apparently this spy or something, and we have to get some stuff going here. Got some party. I do get a kick out of the art style. I like the weird, everyone's got a bunch of square heads, and kind of neat how they do it, actually. Alright, so let's go in here. Okay. Furnace room. Alright, we go into a furnace room. Okay, full space to jump. Fair enough, let's do that. Okay. What do we got here? So it's saying something audibly, but it's all kind of gibberish. I can't really tell what it says. So let's see, deliver the drink to the man with red hair. Okay, I can. It's really garbled, but now that I've read the text visually, I can actually make it out if I really try. So we're going to grab that. Grab that. And now I'm presuming we just get out of here and find the man in the red, with the red hair. And if I remember right, I think I know where he is. So we're just going to wander around. Let me out of here. Thank you. Okay. Walk up here, and I'm pretty sure if I remember right, aha, here we go. Hey, dude, how's it going? Chug it. Alright. Mission accomplished. Now we gotta blow this pop stand. So, you know, again, it's seems kind of simple right now, and it's gonna get weirder. Like I said, I still don't exactly know what the heck is going on, necessarily. And I have not played the sequel, so I have no idea what to expect there. Do I go in the elevator again? Or do I go... Can I go in here? Yes, I can. Yay!
Congratulations. The Manitoba Beast Bug placed into the lime grass was successfully delivered to the target individual. With persistence and ingenuity, we can detect the Manitoba Beast Bug's fumy gases and track the target individual across the galaxy. Our clients are pleased.
Yeah, okay. That was sort of hard to understand, but I believe that's the Microsoft voice. I can't remember her name. Not Anna, but the one they had in XP. They had Microsoft Sam, or Sven, as I would call him, because I just could never, it's just so bad. Can't remember what the name of the lady was. So now we'll just continue on here anyway. Okay. Can we open there? Nope. Okay. Can't do that. I really like the presentation. You know, I mean, it's an indie game. I think it's just made by a couple of dudes. And so I really do like, you know, using the resources that you have to really kind of create a really unique art style. And even the environments themselves, you know, the people have their own look to them too, but I do happen to like just this whole kind of art style. I really do. Oh yeah, this. Okay. Let's try not to screw this up. And hopefully I won't get savagely murdered. Run! Okay, there we go. Okay, I'm back here. Now what do? Oh, okay. Running time. There we go. Alright, I'll pick that up. And okay, so we got some kind of liquid nitrogen stuff and a hammer. So what might we do with that? Let's see what this says here. Okay. So, okay. Bash it. Alright, that's simple enough. There we go, break another lock. Kind of a neat game so far. Here we go. Photograph the five birds. I could actually understand her that time. Sad to say, I can actually understand that. Yeah, I get it. All right, we'll go back out here and see where this gets us. I do happen to know one part that's coming up that I hope I don't screw up too badly. Alright, can we go out here yet? No, we can't. So, we'll just hang a left here. And, you know, even though the graphics are really simpler in this game, I really wish more developers, even mainstream developers or, you know, AAA developers or whatever, I just want to see more color. You know, even we're at night, but even though it's just, I'm really tired of kind of the modern, like, apocalyptic, and everything has to be just beaten down, and there we go. What? Oh, did I not do that right? Hold on. What the hell? Can I get in there? Oh, because I'm an idiot. Alright, sorry guys. Alright, so got a bird. an exploding bird. Fantastic. All right. Oh, okay, yeah, duh, because, okay, I get it. I see what I did wrong before. Two locks. Oh, come on. Open up. Ding. Two birds. And they explode. Okay, we can go all here. Here's the part that I'm not particularly looking forward to, because I've got a feeling I'm going to screw it up. Ah, another bird. Hey, birdie. Hey! Don't close on me there. There we go. Spam. You can just rip. There you go. Explode. So, what we have to now do is, of all things, when I remember playing this for the first time, going, no, you cannot want me to do that. So, come on. Oh, no! Alright, screwed that up. Go do this fast. I guess I should have paid more attention. I wonder if there was a save point closer by. Oh well, I'll look next time. If I do die, jump over there, grab that, grab that. Bust that. There we go. So I did kind of want to play through this. I figured I do want to play the sequel, but I didn't want to play the original again just to refresh my memory, because I don't remember much of the story at all. I remember a few gameplay points here and there. But that's about it. And I just remember this game being really kind of weird when I played it back in the day, so I figured, yeah, you know, let's just cover this on the channel and see what we can do here. Alright. Yoink. Yoink. Dash it. Picture. Got him. Okay. Yoink. Yoink. Dash him. Got two. This one, yes it does. Okay, yoink, yoink. There we go. Hey birdie. Now, I wonder if, let me see if I can, options. Can I not save? Let's try this again here. Oh god! The jumping in this game is really floaty. Oh shit, I'm not. Okay, I did make that. Ooh. I didn't think I was gonna make that jump. Oh yeah, this looks good. Run, 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 run. There we go. I'm gonna make this last jump. Oh no. Oh, yep. Okay. Kinda hate that part, actually. Alright, made that horrible jumping. Just one of the things I really do not like in first-person games of any kind. First-person jumping is just, it's never been fun. Hey. There we go. Roll up, birdie. There we go. What is that, 4 out of 5? I think. But, yeah, I really do not like the things in games that really annoy me are first-person platforming, and I really also do not like water levels. Water levels suck. Load up. Alright, so we got our 5. So so now we gotta leave again, I think. Okay, good. We can use this door now. Can I go this way? Nope. Can't go that way. Oh, man. How do I get out of here again? Okay, that's where I came in. I'm trying to remember how I did that. Can I go through here? Oh, wait, that's where I came. Sorry, guys. This room. Those are birds. Okay, that's going to take me back out there. So I'm going to have to go through the furnace room, I think. I'm trying to remember.
Photograph the five birds.
What we got down here?
Photograph the five birds.
Okay. I don't think I can get up that way, though, can I? Come on. There we go. I cannot. Okay, so how do I... It has been a while, guys, since I have played this, so I know this game is really straightforward, and I know I probably just missed something really stupid, but we'll figure it out. Okay, so we go through here. Is there something... Ah, a vent. How did I overlook that? Okay. Aha! Okay. This is where... Yep. Okay. I know where I am now. Sweet. Okay. Hi. I just got shot. Oh, man. That wasn't very kind. Give me back my camera. Okay, you think you're gonna get away, do you? Alright, we'll chase her. I don't think I know. I can't run, so. Just limping along with my. I mean, my being shot. Chase her down here. Whoa, okay, train. Good thing I did go over there. Alright. Can I go... Do I have... Okay. Go this way. I think we're almost to the end, guys. And then I think what I'll do is after I do beat this part, I think I will stop and start another video. A sequel here. It's kind of got a cool spy feel to it. Here apparently. Whee! Oh jeez. Okay. I'll come back here. Ah! People are like, what the hell are these guys doing? We're running. Running. Gotta catch her. Oh, that can't be good. Okay, and down we go, apparently. What was this supposed to be like? His knife flashing before his eyes, maybe? That's kind of weird. Yep, and if I remember correctly, this is it for Gravity Bone. Weird name for a game, but kind of an interesting little indie experiment there. Really focused on telling a, you know, linear story. Yep. Alright, the end. So I will stop this video here and we'll pick up next time and we will attempt to get through the sequel, which I have never actually played yet. So I'll talk to you guys in a minute.